You might remember this story from a few years back. Thaddeus Jimenez was awarded $25 million from a wrongful conviction lawsuit in 2012. He blew all that money when he got out by spiraling into a life of crime. I sat down with SunTimes reporter Frank Main to try and make some sense of it all.
What happened is in 2015, TJ had all this money, and initially he was doing the right thing. He was working at a Sonic restaurant, trying to make ends meet. Then he gets all this money, and I think that all of a sudden he wanted to exert all the power that he lost when he was a kid, when he was locked away at 13 for a murder he probably didn't do. And so he started spending his money on Lamborghinis and back to his gang roots. There's a videotape that his friend was shooting of him driving around in a Mercedes, and he rolls up to a guy and shoots him in the legs, and that was the end of the story for TJ. He's back in jail now.
I'm interested to know, how did you stumble into the story? What about it hooked you?
There was a girl who was working here as a photojournalist, and she called me one day and she said, "Hey Frank, I live near the MCC, which is a federal jail downtown." She said, "On the rooftop across from the jail, there are these girls who are dancing. They're naked and they're twerking and they're having sex on the roof."
What?
Exactly. And she looked over and all the jail windows were flashing in appreciation of these dancers. She actually had the nerve to go down to the parking garage and talk to one of these girls as she was leaving. They exchanged phone numbers. And one day, this girl got a call from TJ. He said, "I'm the guy that's paying these girls to do this." And I thought, wow, this guy, even in jail, is still working it.
So this guy basically turned himself into a gang leader.
I went back and read all of the original trial testimony in the case where he won all that money, and it was fascinating what happened to this guy over the course of his life, and I wanted to tell that story before all of this stuff happened. And the personal part is just, what does his mother think about all this? She's like the backbone throughout the whole story, and we talked to her from the beginning to the end about why this happened.
The first episode of Motive is now available to listen to. They're going to have a new episode every week for the next 2 months. And we're going to have a link for you on our website with that as well. Really fascinating story.
This is so fascinating. I followed this story from the very beginning. And just the speed at which this kid spent that money was insane. And his reach in the city so quickly got so far.
Yeah, I mean, it's like it could be a movie, right?
Yeah.
The way this is going. I think the biggest takeaway for me when it comes to this is we talk about the crime bill in the 90s era of, you know, tough on crime. And this is kind of showing the effects of that. This is a kid who didn't commit a crime, right? He got out, but he spent all that time in jail. And once you get in that prison system, lots of studies show it's a spiral from there. And this is a kid who spiraled into a life, and now he's right back behind bars.
With zero money left.
With zero money left, yeah.
Unbelievable.
Something else.
Thanks, Brandon.
Great.